first story, you can work up a no price. The first story in the world is there is what called mutual fund or kind of investment. They come and ask you, ask you all the statistics. These people will approach the major shareholder of public company. They buy a block of 10% or what will become 50 million or 100 million. And then they have a big rebate about market rate of 8%. They only have a rebate of 8%. And then they ask us, make sure that until the end of this month, you hold the price, don't let it fall and increase a little bit. So that when I buy this block from you, end of the month, the investment committee meeting will praise me, see, now increase 10 cents, increase 5 cents, and after that, can take out. That is the real world. And normally, election comes in, a lot of funds needed. So they are the group who move the stock market. The second group knows about is the foreign fund. The third group will be people like us who are directors of public company. So when you all go in, we are all coming out. So year after year, you see people keep on throwing their hard-earned money, the vegetable seller, the school teacher, and I keep telling them, have you seen your friend, relative, any one of them become billionaire or become rich or fa-tai choy because they play share market? None, you don't see. So it's all but. So coming back to the whole world, Europe side, in the past they have been having too much consumption based on debts. In fact, the US economy, 75% is consumer spending. So very good that you have Sandy, the window. So we will have some export, like plywood, but that's not really a lot. And the printing will cause global hyperinflation. There will be hot money coming to this part of the world, but still it doesn't solve. The only way to solve is to get Asian asset to increase their import of European and American goods. In fact, there's no solution. In the past, the last 80 odd years, if you stand on the moon and with a telescope look down on Earth, there is a country called America who must hold party every day, enjoy, drink, eat, and then become the world market. And if that country work hard by you and me, the world also collapse. It's unfair, but this is the world. But now it's the first time in world economic history there is a shift of where is the world market, because Asia has always been the manufacturing hub of the world, which we still are. And US has been the main market, and their market in the consumer market, but they do it in the form of debts. That's why whole Europe and whole America has gone to the stage that their debt is 200, and according to Lindsay, they have 256 trillion derivative, about 10 times the world GDP. So for this really to be solved under the normal process of growth, it takes 18 years, your forecast 18 years. So this time, the economic crisis of the whole world is as great as the Great Depression of 1945. So coming back to Asia still has the mentality of being a manufacturing hub of the world. The falling global demand become our Asian concern. There will not be any recession. It's just that all of us tend to look at the political mood of the developed world. So we spend time looking. So Malaysia looks like internally GE13, externally what's going on, because that will shift the direction. See whether they can print money, they can enjoy life, to increase, print money, here whether they can enjoy life, to keep importing. So these are the direction. Of course, within the next two or three more days, the US election, we all know that Obama will win, and the Cuban will win, because Romney, he gives the statistic, he could figure, and not very far from our political rumor. So in America, straight away they confirmed that all his statistics simply lie. So Obama actually took over in 2008, during the peak of the crisis. America immigrated. He could China factory, those who understand Mandarin, to work so hard to create this big word that 今天工作不如意，明天努力找工作。Meaning, today you don't work hard, tomorrow you work very hard to find jobs, something like that. So, this, now what the stocks are piling up, finished goods, raw materials are piling up, new orders are done, we also in reduced price, but this will be temporary. So there will be increase in intra-Asian trade. So this is what's going on in the world. Therefore, Malaysia, how do we react? First, not so bad, Malaysia not so bad. A lot of people come up with all kind of frightening figure. The Bank Negara also acted to me, acted on me. I talked to them, I tried to make sense, but quite difficult. Never mind. Malaysia has only five businesses. One is petroleum. As I told you, the Middle East problem, a short while. Now the petrol price 103, 104 US per barrel is temporary. Because in Europe and America the demand is down. But it will still come back with the Middle East problem with 150, petroleum will come up. As I said, Malaysian government 44% of the government revenue comes from Petronas. So if the petrol price go up, then you can have green, third, green, fifth, green, sixth. But that you have to wait 2018 with the next year G14, the year number, second number, third number. Hopefully by that time the petroleum price is still high. The second business is palm oil. Of course, palm oil now is 2005. In March 2008, it was 4,000 and there is massive campaign against us. You go to France, we have products, put there. Palm oil free product. Just like here, we have cholesterol free, sugar free. In France, they have palm oil free. And in Australia, they go against our palm oil, saying that we cut down our tree in Sabah, Sarawak, and Sarawak especially, to plant palm oil. Therefore, our orangutan have no place to stay. So, but palm oil is still okay because our main export is actually to countries with big population, Latin America, African continent, China, and India. So anyway, those European countries who go again, they are looking soybean oil. So now you need oil, soybean to produce a little bit of oil. Malaysia and Indonesia produce about 80% of the world palm oil. Worldwide about 52 million tons per year. Malaysia already produced 18.9 or 19 million tons. So palm oil is still alright. The price has come down a little bit. The budget 2013 has reduced the export duty to 4.8%. So from when the price at a certain range. So this is to the third one, manufacturing. Manufacturing, they are mostly foreign owners and don't really affect us Malaysian. They are all MMC. The thing that affects is SMI, SMB. But our SMI, SMB are fantastic people. Malaysia now is about 18 world largest trading nation in the world. And mainly because our export plus import is already 1 trillion. 1 trillion. We are 17 largest trading nation in the world. And because our SMI, SMB, they go direct because the MMC come in, and then so SMI will supply the small component. But because of Malaysian, we can speak all kind of languages. And then the Japanese spoken English, the buyers in America, and then our SMI, SMB attend a meeting to discuss with the American. The Japanese cannot talk. Okay, we have to talk. The next meeting, we go there and we photo in the language. So, we became the 18th largest trading nation in the world. So, let manufacturing services sector, we are very, very strong. Very, very strong in our services sector. Especially from the Arab world. We are also champion of the Commonwealth, champion of the third world. You see our education, we are one of the world. In fact, we started in world history, private education. You talk to Taiwanese that in the college, Mr. Lee Lai, you know, Sandy College, I call it. Education is the oldest thing. We created the education industry, our medical tourism, our tourism is also, but of course, you go to Singapore, you see all the foreigners, the white over there. because they concentrate in the off the street, but ours is Junan, Langkawi. So you know, we have some of the very successful tourism. When Ng Yen Yen was the deputy minister of tourism, so she said, "Ask me to help." So we, the Chinese team, went to China, talked to the Chinese tourists, because China tourists, they cannot go anywhere. They can only go to Sima, that means Singapore, Malaysia, Thailand, restricted. So we got captured, so we went there to respond. I was quite surprised that the Chinese minister of tourism was saying that, yes, we have 1.3 billion people, and they like Malaysia for relative closeness of cultural history. But why you send me in yet? I said, the other minister was the Kadir. So she was the deputy, and she being a Chinese, she said, the top. He said, no, first of this, she come here and promote Zheng Heng Tung Temple in Langsung. He said, China got 4,000 temples.